So as we have a working prototype, we should also continue to do some cold cleaning. For example, I just checked that this at types tries to find out the actual value type from the value itself, which is not necessary anymore. So I think I just comment it out. Do you have any problem with that? Yes, of course, because you say that I have, it says that I have the column def, but I don't have the actual attribute type. Calls why not say that I'm looking for column info instead of this? And I just put call info here. And here I also have map links. It's very interesting because let's just call info, because the table ref is should be there in call info for in table info, so I don't need to take it out. It's just in the column info, then I should also I have this thing. That's fine. So actually I collected it. The only thing that I still need is the problem here is that when I create the column info, it is probably Yes. This is the actual entity that's type, and what I would like to do is, because finally I need the actual value type, which I should keep over here. No, it doesn't work because of the syntax error in the bottom of the code, I guess. For now. What's this object resolve? Entity resolver get entity, get key. Let's see. Resolver get key type. Okay. I want to set this here. Because call info, what type? So if that's true, then I don't need it anymore, because the con info already contains the information that I wanted to have. Let's see if it works. Right now I gradually grind down the test codes to a sort of more final solution. I try to init okay. I didn't get any problem, and now I try to run the select. Where I know that the attribute table is long, so I set it. And let's see if the value type is set correctly. It's at def long, so I can believe that it will work. But it does not. Why not? Probably to index. What happened here? Calling for primary key was not set. That's interesting. Let's see how it goes. So run the select again. The column name is store ID. And the store ID, primary key, was not set. How can that be? Okay, this is something I have to return to, because I guess the problem here is that I already have all the data loaded into my connector, so I have too many unit entities. Yeah, quite a lot, and especially I have all the types loaded. So I now delete. Yeah, I have to keep them. Okay, maybe I just commit. Commit executed properly, so I can close and open. Open it again. Oh, circular DB again. Let's see how many entities do I have in a circular DB. 20, which is okay. And I hope I still know that, yes, it's an identifier. I'm happy with that. So now let's run the init function. I will return to that question a bit later. Now what I'm interested in is this point here. I want to run the select, see if the calling for primary key is set now. And it is set. Very good. So now I am able to run the select. and everything works fine. So now I have, I guess, as always, my beautiful store here and the stuff here. And if I select the stuff as well, then it will be populated properly. Yes. Good. That means some information is missing for me that would be very important. Like the fact that this column is of a primary key or not. Can I reproduce this information? Because okay, so I can remove this part here. So the code is just shrinking and getting smarter at the same time. When I called register column, I should do some of the stuff that I do with the column when I create it. This part here. Key data. That should go to a special function here. Let's see. So this should go to a new function, extract method. Data. Init key data. This is how we go. I have the call name, so I don't need it as a parameter. And when I call this, init key data, this for sure. Oh well, let's see if the shutdown hook works. If I just terminate the application. No, it does not. Good to know. So theoretically, Now I can init my database. See if I have all the types. Yes, I can commit. Close, open it again. The point here is that the init key data will not be called from the constructor because the entity is already saved, but it will be called later. And as it is called, the column will know about itself that it's is the primary key. So I can call the init. And the init key is called from the register column, but it is called. So it's primary key, and I am pretty happy about that, because in this way I am sure I can run the select without problems. But I can't, because the value type is not set here. Well. Again, this offset type it gets a bit weirder. But this is when it gets funny. So now the select failed because I can't process it. But now I think it will be corrected. So when I run this select again, let's see. Val type is null. I have another problem here. Whoops. Okay, still okay. Dust ref, ref out type. is null. As at type equals ref at type get key target. Let's see from this point, run again, hello, val type is still null, this is a reference, and now the val type is set, and I am what have I done? Store ID. Now that's because I should also do this for the primary keys. Life. Run again. Let it go. And now it went fine. Check the circular DB and it is. I have the store properly loaded. I have the stuff, and if I run stuff, I get the guys. So, what I have done here is that I started to optimize my access to the actual column data type, but it is now, of course, a bit overcomplicated. What is also visible here is that I have lots of factories that are populated from somewhere. Like this columns thing. And fact data things. But these are always quite similar to each other. So for example, if I take this fact table infos, it will create a table info for me, but I actually Okay. This is disturbing. This shutdown hook thing is simply disturbing. I have to remove it from here. It's just ugly. Things do I have here? Okay. Test UTS shut. Reference, okay, public shutdown aware name. Okay. Shutdown aware public final string name. This exception, big reference, shutdown aware, to shut down, to shut down, shut down aware. to string return name, shutting down down, and try it again. This is what you can do, and you wrap this target, peak reference target, shut down. I can write it like this. And so static. To shut down and shut down wrapper. shutdown wrapper sv shutdown and shutdown wrapper. Sorry. Shutdown wrapper. It's not abstract anymore. New shutdown wrapper. Oh, damn, I just overcomplicated it. Move it to the end so it will not disturb me. Or maybe. With the JDBC ETS. Your method. That's JDBC connector release con. What is the problem with this release con? Sorry, JDBC. And as I am here, I don't have to remove it because the item will be removed automatically. Just there will be no more real reference, only the weak one. So I don't have to deal with that. Okay. Okay, so let's return to the initial question. Did I want to populate a factory? From some external source. So that's DustUtils. New class, that is just populated factory. Superclasses DustUtilsFactory. Okay, DustUtilsFactory, I have a key type, value type that stays the same. And the key type will be string for now. And I need a constructor, which is I will like it ordered. But I need to know the parent entity. I need the link type, and I need the not owner. Okay, then it should be source or target. this is something. Ref key, and the initial population of this factory. Happen like this. Just put Okay. Okay, so no. It's okay now. So this will be the ID, and this will be the other.